It is likely you're watching this video because you or one of your team members has been charged with going to find a project management tool, and that can be really tricky. So we're going to unpack the best ones for you and why they're the best ones. We're going to overview what new AI features are there, what are they best known for, and just general standout features so that you know the lay of the land. You can find all the apps that I mentioned in today's video in the link in description, including today's sponsor, Sensama. If you're looking for a powerful way to organize your to-do list, not your team's to-do list, then it's well worth looking at Sensama. It plugs in with a lot of these project management apps, and it's well worth consideration for weekly planning. So check it out below, as well as the others. So I've got a list here, and we're going to browse through them. And the first one on the list is a pretty well-known one. It's called Monday.com. It's a pretty versatile project management tool that is used as an all-rounder for medium to large-scale teams. Now, there isn't a particular type of team that uses this. It's used all the way from education all the way to large organizations in healthcare. There's so many different use cases for them, but they do have a different type of Monday.com for each different type of person. So for example, if you want to use it for a sales CRM or a CRM system, there's a Monday Sales CRM. There's also a developer version for managing things like standups and processes like that. And there's a more general version, which you might be looking at in this video, called Work Management. So I'll include all of those links below because they're slightly different versions of them that do slightly different things tailored towards slightly different types of people. Now it's priced as free for two seats, but after that, it ranges from £11 to £21 per month, which is around about $10 to $25 per user per month. And obviously that varies in terms of what you get for that. So there is different pricing tiers like all of them. Now the standout features is that you could customize your workflow, what I mentioned with CRM, but it's really simple to use. The application can be set up much like a spreadsheet and tailored towards what your team needs. There's loads of templates to help you get started, as well as automations to help set up micro actions inside of your different activities. They even have some more recent AI features to help to administrate certain tasks. For example, pre-populating fields with information that might be helpful to you. And they plan to increase the AI agents in the future, allowing you to select people or virtual people to do things for you within your team. So think about small administrative or research-based activities for you to get going on. So our second option is Asana. Now this is incredibly well known. It's best known for being an all-round tool. It's very popular with IT, operations, and marketing. And it's used by apparently 85% of Fortune 100 companies. So it's in good stead with a lot of the top companies. Very much like Monday.com, it's used by medium to large size teams, so enterprise teams, but also smaller and bigger ones as well. There's standout features like the timeline feature, which are fantastic for bringing a project to life. You've also got a wide range of project views. Mainly, a lot of people like the strategy-based features, as well as they have over 300 integrations, which makes it incredibly popular for those who want to connect up workflows and get organized as a team. There are some AI features in here. You can set up projects with templates, which helps save you time, sort of like a automatically embedded AI in terms of certain templates. They also have a way to do labels with the AI, as well as an AI chat to do some administrative and research-based tasks based on the context of the task in place. Again, it's free for up to 10 people, but the paid accounts start from £11.50 roughly to £25.50 roughly. So the third option on my list is Wrike. Now this one's incredibly well known as an all-rounder, but it's very popular with marketing and sales teams and agencies. There's some abilities, like some standout features like proofing and automation, that make it popular for marketing teams that want to be able to approve stuff and send on to other departments for moving projects forward. There's some great features in here like visual dashboards and whiteboards for helping bringing ideas to life, but it is just a good solid all-rounder. It's got Gantt charts all the way over to Kanban and has everything in between. There are some AI features. They have an MCP system, which helps you to connect with other popular apps like Claude and many, many more. And they have a administration assistant, but it seems like more of a co-pilot slash chatbot, which can help you and your team to talk to it about the context of a project or task you're working on. It's really popular for medium to large size teams, much more so in enterprise teams more recently. So there is a free tier, but the paid tier is priced at $10 to $25 per year, depending on what you go for. So looking next at Smartsheet, this one is incredibly popular. It is a sponsor of McLaren Formula One. Maybe not the time of this video, but obviously right now as I'm filming. It's a spreadsheet-based style project management tracking software, which is used by enterprise teams, and it's much more suitable for larger teams because you can build bigger sort of setups from this. You can even build apps from this that you can deploy in the field for your team to work on. And it's incredibly popular for that. It's got grid, Gantt, Kanban, calendar views, as well as automations and over 100 integrations as well, and reporting and dashboards, which is helpful as well. The other features are spread across the app. There's auto summaries for certain tasks that you have and abilities to create formulas, which previously took a long time for many people that wanted to quickly generate a formula based on what the input was in the spreadsheet. So the pro starts at $9, the business starts at $19, and there's an enterprise custom plan as well, and that's per user per month. So Notion is become a pretty well-known application now, and if you are a doc-centric team, then you'll like it because it has loads of project management abilities here. You can pretty much build a database of anything. And if you've got one person in your team who loves building and setting things up and systems, then it's a good flexible tool. Probably one of the most flexible tools on our list. It's got custom databases with multiple views, and most importantly, it's got documents, pages, templates that'll help you to create a document wiki for you and your team. It's also got verification and approval on wikis, but I think one of the things that a lot of people like is a database, is because they can just build whatever they want and then their team can constantly use it and refine how they use it. So it's sort of like a custom bit of software to some extent, but there are now Notion projects which help save you time creating all of that. Now there are AI features. There's a little chatbot on the right-hand side which allows you to chat with it across the day. You can pull from other sources like search across Google Drive and many other different platforms to bring in useful information. They also have a way now which you can chat with the Notion AI to essentially build different workspaces, taking the stress out of learning databases, which you and your team might be struggling with in the past or have now. They have a free plan, but the pricing ranges from $10 to $20 per user per month for the more premium pricings. It's used by individuals, but also as teams. It's popular in the creative sector, but for those who are mainly medium-sized teams that are growing as well. So next up is ClickUp. It's known as the one app to replace them all, and that's because it's full of features. The application literally has pretty much every feature you can imagine. It's got whiteboard, chat, and it tries to replace so many different apps in one experience. Well, it does tasks, goals, documents, and dashboards very well, and it has an everything view and over 1,000 integrations apparently. But ClickUp is very much a flexible tool. It might take a little bit of time to learn, but it's great for medium to large size teams, and it's scaling very fast at the moment. In terms of AI features, there's this feature called ClickUp Brain, which allows you to communicate with your entire knowledge base inside of not only ClickUp, but also across the other platforms that you've connected to it. They even have a separate service called Brain Max, which is basically like a AI chatbot for your entire work team, and they're expanding it. It's very early days. So the application is great for tech-savvy small to large-sized teams and those who want to be able to use more forefront AI features to expand and grow faster. It prices as well. There's a free forever plan, but the pricing is $7 to $12. So it's a much more affordable plan that people tend to do when they like to consolidate all their apps into one. Next up is Trello. It's very known as the simple Kanban board experience, but a lot of people like it because there's great power-up features, and it's now obviously owned by Atlassian. Atlassian is a company that has a lot of invested in AI, and it also is invested with other apps like Jira and Confluence. So if you're already using this platform, it's a great add-on to the experience. There's loads of great ways that you can visualize inside of Trello. And more recently, they've added more personal features for planning your own day, including an inbox, a planner, and a board feature as well. You can use it for free for up to 10 boards, but the pricing ranges between $5 and $10 per user per month. So again, a more affordable pricing in terms of the other options in this list. But it's great for teams who may want something more approachable and that they can use with their other tools like Jira, Confluence, and more. So Zoho Projects is another option. It's very budget-friendly all-rounder. It's got all of the traditional things you'd see inside of a project management, like Gantt, Kanban, milestones, time tracking, and it's got a really deep Zoho ecosystem focus. So if you already use Zoho apps across the suite, then you'll probably like this one because you can plug it in with them and integrate them deeply as well. Now, the pricing of it makes it really affordable. It's free up to free users, but you can get access for it $5 to $10 per user per month, which makes it fairly affordable for a lot of teams that are fairly small. It's great for small to medium-sized businesses, as well as large businesses, but I typically see medium-sized businesses use it. It also has some AI features, like an assistant called Zia. It also has insights, automations, and assistive AI to chat with the assistant about the different projects you're working on. So my final recommendation for you is a smaller one. It's actually an AI AI-focused project management tool, and it's called Motion. Not Notion, Motion. The application is grown on me over the last couple of months because it's tailored its focus towards AI, meaning small to medium-sized teams can use this. I'd probably say a team of up to 50 could use this. And what's different about it is it helps you plan your tasks, and then it helps you to schedule what those tasks look like in your plan, which means you and your team can schedule loads of stuff for each other and be able to create this plan for yourself for the day. It also has documents, AI agents as part of it, and more AI-based planning features. So if you want to be on the forefront of AI and start using smaller Erin-based task management and planning systems to help you plan your tasks, then I think this probably is a bit of a more of a risk in terms of like, okay, it's a new tool, but I think it's actually one that's going to favor entrepreneurs or small teams or even busy managers that want to be able to organize their day more effectively. So it's project management scheduling combined with AI powered scheduling for yourself. So an interesting combination. So those are the 10 project management tools in 2025. You can check them all out in the link in the description. We'll include any other resources or deals that we have on these tools, and they'll be linked below as well. Thank you very much for stopping by in today's video, and I hope this helped you to find the best tools on the market. Thanks very much, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.